Hello, good day to you. How are you doing? We are talking to Doug Grewer this morning, CEO at EMUNL. Doug, good morning to you. How are you?
Oh, good morning, Gal. Very well, thank you.
We're glad to hear it. Listen, I understand you've got some promising nickel targets from surveys at a couple of your projects in the Wheat Belt. Tell us a bit about them and what you found.
Yeah, sure, Gal. Yeah, well, we've just recently released results from a geophysical survey we did with fixed loop electromagnetic survey over our Graceland project and also our Viper project, both of those in the Wheat Belt under Wheat Farm. We've been very, very excited by the, particularly at Graceland, where we've found that coincident with geochem auger drilling that we did earlier in the year, late last year, and with some reprocessing of some magnetics, we've been able to delineate a number of conductors, which are giving us some walk-up drill targets in that area, which we're actually planning for a drill program in the next few months out at Graceland and also at Viper. Viper is an old copper project, a historic copper mine, where we've also got some geochem anomalism, and we've picked up some conductors around that as well. So we're very excited about those two projects in particular. Joel, yes.
Yeah, give us a bit more details and background about what you've going on in the region, because I understand you've got a third one, Sunfire, as well. Where do all these three fit into your broader portfolio, and what's their significance to you at the moment?
Yeah, sure. So Sunfire is a project that we haven't yet put our boots onto the ground. We're still finalising some of the admin and process issues, but we're very excited about Sunfire. It sits and abuts the Chalice Mines venture, Southwest Nickel project, where they have done some great work and picked up about 20 EM conductors and also found some nickel sulfides on the end of a drill hole. So we are pretty excited about what is there. It's had some drilling done on there before. Some of it goes back over 50 years, and that drill at Sunfire has produced nickel sulfide. So when we start our work there, which will involve some geochemistry and also some fixed loop electromagnetic surveys like we've done on the Wheat Belt properties, we're expectant that we're going to pick up some really interesting targets for us to drill. So it's a very, very good area to be in, albeit that it takes a bit of processing being in the southwest amongst the forestry and the farming areas. We're pretty excited about what Sunfire might deliver for us in the future, particularly with copper and more so with nickel, both which are very anomalous in that zone.
Yeah, nickel in particular, with the market the way it is, prices soaring at the moment, of course. You know, you must be presumably quite keen to get things out of the ground as quickly as possible. Can you give us an idea about timelines and what next steps are involved at those particular projects?
Yeah, sure. So I think we'll be on in Sunfire within the next 6 months. We'll be on the ground there and completing fixed loop electromagnetic surveys and geochem soils program there. Ultimately going in for vectors on nickel, on drilling targets into the nickel zones. At Viper and Graceland, we're planning a drill program to look at the conductors that have been picked up in the recent surveys, the geophysics surveys. We're looking at around about 4 to 5 months to be in those zones. And in the meantime, we've got some other areas which we're focusing in on with our other projects, but particularly with nickel, those three projects will be boots on ground before the end of the year, and hopefully be drilling all of those targets.
Yeah, all right. Well, looking ahead to the rest of the year, then what else have you got on the plate? What else are you looking ahead to?
Well, the last 12 months we've put 18 kilometres of drilling, RC drilling, into our gold project up at Yalgoo in Western Australia. That's produced some very, very significant high grade intercepts. We've got another around about 3,000 metres that we've planned, and we're about to start that program in the next few weeks. We've also been able to find some very high grades of tungsten, and we're just waiting for element-specific assays to come back on those, Joel. We're very confident we're going to have some extremely high tungsten grades from that area. And so coincident with gold, we'll be looking in the drilling program for the occurrence of tungsten. So we're really excited about that too. We're very, very fortunate and blessed to have such really great projects. But the Badger project, as we call it at Yalgoo, we should have some results from drilling as soon as the assay is done, perhaps in a couple of months' time.
Great. Well, look, plenty on your plate, plenty to keep you busy, plenty to keep your eye on, and certainly plenty to hopefully inform us about in those coming months.
Look forward to it, Joel. Thanks very much.
Thanks, Doug.